Hi, welcome to Big Data Pedia. Today we are going to discuss a small project with 120 millions of record in AWS environment. Before, we have discussed a few projects with Raspberry Pi and 8 open sources in standalone mode. So this time we are going to using AWS services to handling the project in normal corporate level. So here I am using three services, and we will discuss the flow architecture. This is the sample architecture. I am using three services here. The same three services, mostly in Big Data environment, they will be using. So first one is AWS S3, which will be used for storage services, and EMR cluster that they will be doing for aggregations or some Hadoop environment they will be using. And once they will be complete their aggregations, and finally they will be going to load into some databases that they are calling as an RDS. So here I am using MySQL databases to loading the data. This is the flow that we will be going to use for 120 millions of records. So here we just going to be work with end-to-end project, how we can creating these services and how to utilize it, and finally how to terminate that all. That's we are going to see it. And I am taking two scenarios for the data set, because the AWS services cost is very high, so we will not be going much in that. I just take it out only two problem scenario. So based on the data, it's a airlines data set. So based on the data set that I'm doing some aggregations for month-wise total distance traveled by each flights, and another one is month-wise how many get diverted. So these two scenarios that I'm going to use it. Okay. Now we can start from all the services one by one, how to create it. So this is the AWS environment. Here you can just select the services. You can get all the services. So you're just going to select this S3. It will come under to storage. So S3 services is nothing but it will be storing your data as an object. So any other services can retrieve from here. This is a common directory only. So simply we can using this create bucket, and we can provide some unique name for this bucket. So I just mentioning as AWS Airlines 2019. So that's I just using it. Next, it will be versioning as well as server access. Any logs, so if we need to load into S3 bucket itself, then we can using that. And here you can see this is the block public access. If it is enabled, then you cannot access via public. So we need to get some encryption keys or ACL keys that we can access to S3 bucket. So we just untick that, then access via public as well. So if you untick this one, it will be support for all these four. This is a summary data. What you are going to provide this properties for this S3 bucket that you can see here, and provide create bucket. That's it. So now that bucket is created. Now you just load the data. I'm going to create a new folder. So just like test. And they will be providing some encryption keys, AES and AWS KMS keys. Via this, you can access the data as an encryption key way. You can handling your data. That's the use of this key. For this sample scenario, we will not be using this. We just using as a none only. So I just click on save. Now it will be open. So now the folder is created. And once you come to that test directory, you just select this upload and upload your files. Okay, this is the airlines data only that I am using. So simple, I just load one file for the sample test practice. So here it will be asking for the read write operations. So if it is selected all of this, then it will be have full access. If we don't want anything, then you can just choose only for read access or write access. Like that you can provide it. And I am using a standard only. So I just selected for the standard storage classes. That's it. So now it will be load here. You can see this. So this is a very less KB of data only. So within a fact, just load it. This is the way you can upload a file here. Otherwise, you can using AWS CLI to upload via command. And another one way is we can copy from another one bucket to this bucket. So this is the existing one. I just go and copy this input. This is the actual input, so I just copy this and I'm going to paste here. So just calculate how much the data is available. So it's close to 1.1 GB of data, and it's the file is ORC file format that I am using here. Okay, now it's just get started and it's copying. Once it's completely copied, we can see the data how it looks like. Okay, now it's copied. Just open that input and you can see actual data. So this is the ORC with 1.1 GB. This is actual data. We are going to handle this data via EMR. So now we know how we can creating a bucket and how we can load the data and how we can copy and paste from one bucket to another bucket. Okay, that's it for S3 services creation. Now we can going to create another one in EMR services. So same like that, you just click EMR, sorry, the services, and go to the EMR. It will come under to analytics. Just click EMR. Okay, 1 minute. Before going that, we just going to copy the path, because we will be using this path for our big data operation. Now you just go to analytics and select EMR. So already I have used a lot of cluster buckets, so I just copy the same and clone it back. But I can explain you for my references, I just cloned, but I can explain you from the first to end. So go to the service software and steps. I just select the software configuration to 5.228. This is the latest one. Apart from 6x services are in beta, so this is the latest and stable one thing. So I just select that. It will come with Hadoop and Ganglia, Zeppelin and Spark. Now I am going to use this EMR service as a Spark cluster. So I just mainly selected for Spark, Hadoop integration and a Ganglia. This is enough for Spark cluster access. And you can see this is an AWS Glue data logs. If you are going to do any ETL operation via Spark, then you can select this. Otherwise, you don't want to select this. Okay. So if you need to provide any software settings, you can provide the setting configurations here itself. And steps, while you are going to kick up this EMR cluster, at the time you need to do any steps, you can provide the steps. So if you need to include any custom jobs or Spark, peak program or high program, streaming, whatever, it's going to be kickstart automatically, then we can use it. But right now we didn't do, we will be doing some batch processing only. So we didn't select anything. And come to this hardware configuration. In a hardware configuration, we will be selecting a virtual private network. So this is the default network that I am using and easy to subnet that I selected. And here it will be providing multiple instances. If you need to change the instances, you just click this and you can see the machine type as well as number of core it will be commanded to that machine as well as memory. And you just go. I just choose to M5 2X large services. It will come with the 8 core and 32 GB RAM, and EBU services will be allowed. The same I just select for slave as well. So total, this is a 4 node cluster. One instance as a master, rest of 3 will be going to be work with slave operation. That I just selected here. Okay. Then if you need to load any log information into S3 bucket, then click this logs. This will be represent one AWS S3 folder. If you don't want to load any logs, then untick that. And tag information you can provide as well. And go to the security. In security, I can providing this PPK key. This is the EC2 key pair. This is actually PPK, PuTTY private key. So this PPK key helps to log in your Hadoop environment, EMR cluster environment without password. So that is the main use of this PPK key. I am using this PPK Big Data PuTTY key. And this is a role. So I just click that role. This is a kind of policy. EMR default role is a kind of policy they will be provided. Here you can see the Elastic MapReduce role, as well as I just providing Amazon S3 full access. If you are going to attach this policy, then only you can access via S3 bucket in EMR. If you don't have this S3 full access role, then you cannot access that. So be ensured before creating EMR cluster, you just include this policy. The rest of the same only. Nothing security configuration, rest of the same only. Everything is fine now. I just going to create a cluster. Now it's started. And all the information you can get from here. In this time being, we can see how we can providing this SSH key. This is the key already I have loaded, so just copy it, and you can go to the SSH key and go to authentication. There you can provide that private key. This key you can create via PuTTY generator. As a public and private, you can get, and you just save that key anywhere. And the same key you can upload into AWS environment, then only you can access that. Go to the session. Now I just used a cluster in starting state. Now cluster is started, but it's still in starting. If it is comes to waiting state, then only you can use it. Okay, we will wait for some time. Still it is starting. Now it's configuring the cluster software, everything. Before your waiting state, if you are trying to access this EMR cluster, you will not be access other services, because it, right now based on the policies, this is going to be configured. So once the cluster is ready, then only you can use it. So already I just copy the path here. This is the S3 bucket path. So configuring cluster software is taking some time. Now it's back to waiting state now. Okay, then it will be cluster ready for run steps. Then you just select this SSH key and copy this environment. This is the host name as well as user ID. You just copy and open to the PuTTY and paste here and save and click open. Then it will be accessed for the security alert. Once provided as automatically, this is going to be connected and EMR just kickstarted. Okay, so now we just create a cluster EMR and utilize it. For the next video, we can see how we will be doing our PySpark integration as well as RDS table integration. That we will be seeing next video. Thank you.